This is a video about Introduction to MATLAB for the IEA216 course entitled Computer Applications in Industry. And this is the component for MATLAB. I'm Yusri Yusup, and I'll be the instructor for this component. We'll start off with the overall course details, but this could include some discussion on the other component of the IEA216 course, the AutoCAD component. I will just talk about the course outline in general, but the topics that I will discuss is mainly the MATLAB component. The overall course objectives are to instruct students on the application of two industry standard software used in science and engineering. The students will also be taught on how to perform basic programming using MATLAB, but mainly for data analysis. MATLAB emphasizes the use of mathematics in computer programming to solve engineering or scientific problems. The overall learning outcomes are, at the end of this course, the student will be able to organize data and determine suitable programming commands and statistical commands in MATLAB or R, although R is not a part of this course yet. The student will also be able to develop a function in MATLAB or R, and also the accompanying flowchart to summarize graphically how does the function behave. And preferably this function will be a useful function that the students will need to think of ideas on how to develop a useful function and how can you use the function to solve problems. So the general course outline or the topics will be taught for the MATLAB component of this course is, number one, will be covered in this video as well, the introduction to MATLAB on what is MATLAB and why we want to use MATLAB. The second topic will be to understand the MATLAB environment. How do we navigate the MATLAB window, the MATLAB program, and other parts of the graphical user interface. Number three is to understand the fundamentals of programming, specifically the control and flow commands, which is not specific to MATLAB. You can also use the same concepts in other scripting and programming languages. But here we'll be using MATLAB as an example to learn these programming concepts. Number four is you will learn how to import data into MATLAB and also what are functions and how to develop the functions in MATLAB. This is the useful function that I mentioned in the previous slide. The fifth topic is on algorithm. The general idea of what an algorithm is or how do we use that concept in programming to make the programming process more structured and more simple. And also, how do we plot in MATLAB? And the sixth and seventh topic on the many statistical tools that is available in MATLAB, and that's covered in two separate topics. So let's go into the introduction to MATLAB. First, let's look at when was MATLAB developed or what does MATLAB stands for. It is coined from two words, that is matrix laboratory. And it was created or developed in the late 1970s, and it was for the purpose of teaching courses in mathematics and in matrix, such as matrix theory, linear algebra, and also numerical analysis. But now MATLAB has grown into an interactive system, and also it has grown into a high-level programming language, and it is used by the scientific and technical computational crowd. So why MATLAB? So common uses of MATLAB in research to, one, acquire data, and two, it is multi-platform, is very versatile in terms of where you can install MATLAB, where you can use it, as well as the type of data that it can handle. Number three, you can use MATLAB to analyze data because there's many tools in the default installation of MATLAB, as well as the many extra toolboxes available by MathWorks. And you can also, if these tools are not up to your requirements, then you can develop your own tools in MATLAB. You can also use MATLAB for statistical analysis, and we'll be touching upon that in the last two topics of this component, of course, because there are, again, many tools available in MATLAB. Number five, to produce publication professional-looking plots. And number six is that you can also use MATLAB to model, although the modeling component referred to using Simulink to model processes. So the first reason, data acquisition. So now you can directly link Raspberry Pi and Arduino mini PCs that you can deploy on the field with sensors attached to them, and directly connect these devices to MATLAB through either Ethernet connection or a USB connection to download the data or to see the data or observe the data in real time. You also want to use MATLAB because it's very versatile. You can install it in Windows, you can install it in Linux, you can install it in macOS, the three main operating systems. And besides that, you can also import many types of data into MATLAB. For the majority of users of MATLAB, they will deal with ASCII types of data. ASCII files are basically just text files. You've seen them before and you would open them using Notepad or text edit. And the ASCII files are basically files that you'll be able to read directly. In contrast, the other types of files you will not be able to read directly will be the binary data files, where it's a data file which consists of just ones and zeros or in characters that you don't understand. MATLAB will also be able to read this kind of data. So you also use MATLAB because it has many tools, analysis tools available, either in the default installation of MATLAB or in toolboxes that you can subscribe to or download. It also provides a very robust framework for you to design and create custom analysis tool if the tools that's available in MATLAB is not up to your requirement. You can also use MATLAB for statistical analysis because there are many statistical tools. The basic ones that you see here is just the tip of the iceberg. We have the t-test, the Mann-Whitney test, rank sum test, ANOVA, linear regression, and curve fitting. Although curve fitting is available in a toolbox that is separate that you can download. And you can also use MATLAB to produce publication professional looking plots. It has a compressive array of plotting options that can go from 2 to the 4th dimension. So these are the basic 2D plots and the 3rd three-dimensional plot. And also you have full control of how these plots look, because you can control the format, you can control the axes and other visual representational elements. And finally, we use MATLAB model complex dynamic system. When we say that we would model using MATLAB, it means to the Simulink component of MATLAB, not the default MATLAB application. With that said, you could still use MATLAB to model if you code the numerical analysis. Then you could essentially model in MATLAB, although it might not be as efficient as compiled languages such as C++ or Fortran. So that is the end of this video on using MATLAB. I think it serves the purpose of giving you a rough idea of what MATLAB is. And in the next video, we'll be looking at how do we navigate the MATLAB interface, and hope to see you there soon. Thanks and bye.